Okay, here we are, still at the Montreal World Film Festival, and we're now talking to some rising filmmakers. I always like to bring you fabulous new talent first, you know that, and so does the Montreal Film Festival. And they're really, really kicking it this year, and I saw this wonderful film. I don't usually do shorts, as you know, but if they're this good, I felt I had to do it. It was a film called Chum. These aren't two people I'm dating, by the way. They're just, this is the poster of the movie, and these are the two main characters. And we're here with Jorundur Ragnarsson from Iceland, who is the filmmaker, and Elizabeth Rose, and you wrote it?
Co-wrote it and produced it.
Oh, wow. Well,
co-produced
well.
It with lots
Enchanté
of people.
De faire votre connaissance, mademoiselle.
Nope.
You don't speak French. All right. I speak a little Iceland. I can say Fraubart.
Fraubart. Oh, yeah. Great.
Which means fabulous in Icelandic. And then I say, can say tak and bless, and that, which means goodbye and thanks. So good, no. Anyway, welcome, Jorundur. So what's the word for welcome in Iceland?
Velkomin.
Well, it's so much simpler than you think, yeah. Iceland. It was like, I miss it so much, and it was like a trip to Iceland watching your movie.
Oh, yeah.
That was
done
through Columbia Film School, which I was like blown away when you made that introduction. I thought, Iceland, Columbia Film School, this could really work, you know.
Yeah. There are a few people from Iceland that have done that program.
Oh, yes, really?
Yeah. So, quite a lot, actually, like 8 people, I think.
Okay. Yeah. Well, usually, I mean, I thought I met everybody in the Icelandic film business, but...
Well, they're all like up and coming young filmmakers.
Now, but it used to be there was only Friedrich Thor Friedrichsen, who is still here. He's a judge with a film called Of Horses and Men, which I haven't seen, but he's saying, you'll see my movie, you know. And Balthazar Kormacher, who I discovered, and look what happened to him, and Hilmir Snive.
I know them, yeah.
And you know Hilmir very well.
Yeah.
We all know how Balthazar is doing. He's practically become an American A-list director, as I knew he would.
Yeah. He's very successful.
So you shouldn't just sit there and agree with me. But let me, since you are, I will tell you about where I interviewed Friedrich Thor Friedrichsen first.
Oh, yeah?
He had me interview him in Anna Maria Karlsdotter's bathroom. saw that episode, you would be laughing too. It was all, I don't know if she still lives there, but it was all white walls and it was big. And, you know, you just couldn't believe this was a bathroom. It was like a living room in most people's houses in New York, you know.
We usually do interviews in bathrooms, but...
Well, Friedrich was, he was never able to top that. And we've already done 5 minutes and you guys haven't said anything, so...
No, the only question I got was about the Icelandic word welcome.
Okay. Tell us about your film, Thorundur. Jorundur with a J.
I don't know. It was shot in a beautiful small seaside village in Iceland. We did it for no money at all. It's a school project, so everyone gave their work, and we got a lot of help from the villagers. We shot it in 4 days, and the outcome was surprisingly good. We're very proud of it.
Was very well written.
Oh, yeah.
Very well performed, very well cast. And as Slava, my cameraman, said to you, the color correction was great.
Oh, yeah.
But it wasn't the first thing I come out of there. Think about all those beautiful fjords, volcano. What was that we were looking at in the background there?
Oh, it's just an isolated village.
What's
population
the name again?
Of 400 people. It's called Patreksfjörður. My sister's sister lives there. She's lived there for 30 years, and she helped a lot. So, and we know a lot of people there, so we got free food, and the villagers were really friendly and nice.
It looked wonderful. I wanted to go there. It was like a travelogue for Iceland. But it's about what is the story of your film?
Well, it's about the friendship of these two men. They're both. Alone. One of them is a widower, but the other one has never been with a woman that we know of, unless he's very, very drunk. So what happens is that a woman their age is coming to the village and is going to stay there for a few months, and one of them is attracted to her, and that's kind of throws
and
their friendship
into
peril.
And they're all of the same age. And who played the woman in the story?
Anna Kristín Arngrímsdóttir. I know I'm an actor myself. She played my mom in a TV series I was acting,
okay. And what are the names of these two wonderful actors? We should just say them because I love hearing Icelandic spoken. You know,
this is Sigurður Skúlason and this is Theodor Júlíusson. Both very good actors and nice people.
Yes, well, I love Iceland, as I said, and you know, everybody in Iceland has these unusual names because you're all named after your first name is yours and then your father.
Yeah, we have no family names almost.
Right. Yeah. Right. So Friedrich said to me, what was my father's name? And I said, Joseph. So he said, you would be Steppy Josephson. So then he called me Steppy from then on. Elizabeth, what was your father's name, first name?
Peter.
So you would be Elizabeth Peter's daughter if you lived in Iceland.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
But you don't. So... Yeah. It was, you know, Columbia Film School is often criticized for being too intellectual.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah, and you never heard that before.
No.
No, I've heard that we're commercial. That's what NYU kids say about us.
Oh, really? Well, it's this whole theory, and it's not about, you know, the work. Where I would say NYU was the commercial place if you had to ask an expert, you know.
Okay.
But Columbia is very well thought of. Great teachers there. Great,
yeah,
some of the great teachers of our time are there.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, it's a very good
They must
program.
Have been very happy about how well your film turned out compared with the rest of the stuff from students or something that I've seen.
There have been some amazing films coming out of the school.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Were they happy with your project?
Yes. I got a lot of compliments and. Yeah,
you deserve them too. It was so funny, and you felt for these two lonely guys, and then this woman who looks like she's had one too many facelift turns up in a hot tub, what's the word in Iceland?
Hot
springs.
Heitur pottur, like hot pot.
I went at the beginning of the film. I went, I've been there, you know, but it wasn't. It was in the small town because I've just been in Reykjavik, you know.
Yeah. They have these great swimming pools in these small villages. It's a nice contrast, like these new swimming pools.
These hot springs are in Iceland. They're volcanic and they come up from the volcano and they heat the whole country basically.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a lot of hot water there.
Green, it's green too. It's all natural, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, geothermal or something.
Yeah. Yes, that's geothermal. It. Thank you. Yeah. The writer has the words that I should have them too. But it's wonderful. It was. So how do you feel about Montreal?
It's great. It's the first time I attend a film festival.
No
even
kidding.
As a guest. Yeah. So it's been very exciting. And my first film.
This is your first film.
Yeah.
It did not seem that way. It seemed so assured and mature.
Oh, thank you.
Do you come from a theatrical background in
Iceland? Well, I'm an actor, so...
Oh, you're an actor. Okay.
I worked as an actor for 6 years in Iceland before I...
In the National Theatre?
Both the National Theatre and City Theatre and did some TV and films.
So now I'm going to forget the name of the lady who runs the National Theatre in Iceland. And she's Tinna Gudnadóttir.
Tinna,
she's been on my show too.
Oh, okay.
Everybody's been on my show. I got everybody. I didn't realize that was it, you know. Mm. And then from then on, I'll be meeting the same people over and over and over again and interviewing the same people. But there's a new generation springing up, yourself included.
Yeah, that happens.
Of talent. But it's something about Icelandic. Maybe you felt this, Elizabeth. I've got to ask you a question. Have you been to Iceland?
I have not been to Iceland.
Oh, you're kidding me.
She's going to come next summer.
I'm going to come next summer. I'm from Montreal, though.
Oh. Oh, well. Yeah. Close, but no cigar. Okay, but Montreal's fabulous.
Yeah.
You've been to the film festival in here.
I only lived here until I was six.
Oh.
And then I grew up in the States.
Oh, okay. But where in the States?
In Boston.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, my cameraman is looking at his watch. The film really was funny. It was touching. It was interesting, you know, it really moved, it really held my attention. I couldn't believe it was a student film, and I couldn't believe it was your first film. Jorundur.
Yes.
What did they call you for short? Yuri?
Yuri.
Yuri. Yeah. Yuri. That's easier to remember. Yeah. So what are you going to do next?
Well, we're still in school, so I have 2 years to graduate. I'm writing a feature script, so hopefully I'll do that one day.
Well, keep me posted.
Yes, definitely.
The door is always open. You know,
thank you.
I should ask, you know, a little bit more about Iceland if we have the time, just, you know, because I was there when in 1990 and 2000 when it was, you know, on the bubble, I guess, or before the, you know, economic boom.
Yeah, right
boom.
Before, yeah.
And then there was a collapse, which we have 1 minute to talk about.
Yeah.
Where is it now?
I mean, I think it's going up again. I mean, yeah, we had a collapse, but, like, in comparison with, like, I think, like, we're doing fine. Even after the collapse, there's not much poverty or like, hunger. Or, like, we're not dealing with serious issues like that. So, yeah, I think we're doing
okay. But anyway, that's just how it goes in show business in the States. But I hope to see you soon or often. And please invite me to whatever films you're being shown at Columbia Film School.
Come up to Columbia.
I will. I can get on the subway still and travel there. So.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Please do.
And when I show you my card, it was the picture. I'm not going to show it on the air. It was a picture of me taken with Hilmer, but I cut him out. But you'll see this strange expression on my face. It's because I was so happy to be with Hilmer in Iceland. Hilmer Snive Gunnarsson. Anyway, Jorundur Ragnarsson and Elizabeth Rose, thank you so much for being here today with Chum. I guess it means that they were chums. Friendship, you know.